What's up, everyone, and welcome to the channel. Hero here and Alvin from First Timers.
Yep, you're superstars of the show.
Superstars of the show, and welcome to the Vehicle Project Series, and this is our El Camino.
Yep, we are pretty much been working on it. You guys, I know you haven't seen too much of it, but we'll be getting back onto that shortly. Did order a lot of parts. We do want to get to the exhaust, but I think we might be doing some interior work first.
Yeah, because look at it.
Yeah, so it kind of looks a little sad. So we'll get to that point.
But we fixed a major issue, which was the oil leak.
And yes.
That's no longer happening. Yeah, now.
And if you guys haven't, I guess we didn't do a real video on that. We did it lifting up the car.
Yeah.
You know, and we bought some jack stands for that lift. That's actually pretty cool.
Yep.
But anyway. We're going to be installing a new headlight switch,
yep,
and since
right
we don't have a dash in,
makes it easier.
Yeah, it makes it easy right
might
now.
Might as well take care of it.
Yep, and we can kind of show you exactly what things look like on the inside and how this is supposed to look when we plug it in.
And the reason why we're replacing it, it's not that it's not working, but it's not working properly.
Yep.
When you pull it back, sometimes the headlight won't work,
yeah,
or the brake light. So it's like, this handles all the lights,
yeah, and
technically.
I think there's like a contact issue. So keep in mind, when I got this car, if you haven't been caught up on this, it didn't have a windshield, didn't have a rear window. Dash pretty much was destroyed. Water was leaking in, so there's a lot of surface rust in here. So I'm assuming the connections and stuff are bad, so when you try to adjust it and all that junk, it's not perfect. So
corroded.
Yeah, so yeah.
So we're just gonna unbox this real quick and show you what it looks like and then get to installing it.
Let's do it.
Nothing else in the box.
No instructions.
No instructions. If you can't install this, take it to a shop.
No, what was that from Fast and the Furious? If you can't find the right tool,
you don't belong.
Yeah,
you don't belong in this garage.
So this one, if you can't install it without instructions, you don't belong in the first timer's garage.
There you go. A little contact here.
Sorry, guys.
Yeah, that's it right there. All the functionality is in here.
Yeah. Now, guys, just so you know, right on the back, there's this little button. So this is actually what's going to release the lever, the pull lever, out of there. So I'll kind of show it when Hero gets to it on the inside. I'll move the camera over the windshield so you guys can kind of take a look at it there. But you push it down and then you just pull right out. Hopefully. Yeah,
theoretically,
yes.
All right.
So you guys can kind of see that button there. So Hero's gonna push it down there and then pull the lever on the front. So you have to push it all the way in and then just start to pull it. You might have to rotate too, to like an, as you're pulling on it and push it in. Feels like it's supposed to do that. So Hero's struggling a little bit, guys.
I pushed it all the way in, but no budge.
No budge.
No budge.
All right, let me see if I can do it.
Hold on. Go.
Nice, there it goes.
All right, guys, so pretty much you can kind of see this is the old one here. I'm still gonna be using this switch for right now. I did not buy a new one. So pretty much when we pushed it, I already had it partially out already. And then, Hero was pushing it, as you can see in the video. And then I pushed it back in and then I pulled it back out. So it was that easy to do. So I just slightly pushed it in. You kind of hear like a little click and then pull it right out. Now, my thought, from what everybody else was saying, is you're just supposed to be able to push it and then you pull it out. That wasn't the case.
Yeah.
So, pretty much, yeah, it's out. Like I said, I should get a new one, but
it looks
fine.
Good. Yeah, it looks good.
No one's gonna see it most of the time. But when I get everything done in here, then yes, I'll swap it.
It's got the patina.
Yep, it has the patina right now. But now we're gonna use. Actually, it's not even on that tight. Look at that. And just so usually you have a big enough screwdriver to undo this, but this is actually coming off on its own. It's like a little, I forget what they call these style pieces here, but anyway, it's
so it
going.
Just unscrews.
Yep.
All right.
But you just need a screwdriver to do it properly. Actually, we have this screwdriver.
You need a fat one.
Nah.
Oh, okay. I see.
Yeah, so if you do have a nice car, obviously take your time. You don't want to scratch or damage any of your plastic.
Dang, what are you calling this car? Not a nice car?
It's not a nice car.
Dang, as of yet. The El Camino's sad right now. It's crying.
So we're just going to pull the wires here, and that's it. So it just pulls right out. Very simple.
Oh, look at all that dust. Oh.
Again, that's from pretty much no windshield in the car.
Oh, man.
And so this is actually what works the dimmer on the for the lights on the inside. So this would rotate as it moves around, and it makes more contact or less contact to, you know, adjust the brightness. And for a close-up shot, this was the button that we were talking about pushing. And you can definitely see how,
the rust.
Yeah, how nasty this looks.
Ugh.
Yeah, so anyway, we're gonna swap it out and
test it.
Yeah, we'll see if we can get the new one working properly like it should.
Ooh.
So what I'm gonna do before I do anything is I'm gonna take a really thin flat blade screwdriver, and I'm gonna start to scrape the contacts just because I'm here right at the moment and I wanna make sure I clear these all off. But it shouldn't be too hard or too crazy. But yeah, just give me a few and we'll get these cleaned up just so we know we're making perfect connections. So. And just to kind of show you guys what's on there.
Dirty.
It's not great. Yeah, so let's try to, like I said, try to clean each one. You can kind of see the one I was working on there. Do one at a time. Don't try to cross these
connections.
These connections, yeah, because, yeah.
Spark.
Yeah.
Fire.
Or you don't want to mess up anything, yeah. But just take your time, and especially if you have a new windshield in there too, again, please don't scratch anything. Use the smallest flat head you can and scrape away, guys. So here's the new switch. Now we're gonna plug it on. You can see a lot of the contacts look a lot better, a lot shinier. I didn't do a perfect job, but I just wanted to make sure that it was golden. So I'm gonna push it on.
It looks golden. Not rusty, brown.
There we go. And then actually, there's a plate right here. Does that look too rusty or no?
Let me see, stop moving your finger. No, the plate looks good.
Okay.
Yeah,
that's
not rusted
ground,
at all.
That's a ground.
It's the ground, yes. I see a ground wire to it.
Yeah. It's getting hot. All right, there we go. Slightly tighten it down. Again, reusing the old piece, but at some point I'll probably buy a new one. But once we get to the dash, like I said, right now we're just not at the dash yet. So. There it is. Oh, snap.
Dude, you can actually feel the clicks.
Yeah, I know.
Last time it wasn't clicking.
It didn't have the click.
Yeah.
Oh,
okay.
As you rotate, you can feel all the new spring clicks.
Rotate.
That is dope, guys.
The clicks are like the most noticeable thing.
Yeah, I know. It's just like click, click, click.
All right. It's installed.
Guys, yeah. It's easy. We did move into a different project on the back, dealing with, again, electrical, our lights. But we won't get into that because it's going to be some body work that's going to be happening on the quarters at some point. So we'll actually start that project hopefully soon. But other than that, like I said, the light switch went in. We will have that product in the link down in the description.
Yep.
Yeah, so I know it's probably not your full-on Concorde restoration part, but it's doing the job. It's for the driver.
Yeah.
Yeah. So.
A noticeable improvement in the clicks when you were pulling the lever.
You can feel it. Yeah. It's just like click, 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 and then spinning and all that stuff. But yeah,
it works.
It works. It's awesome. So anyway, don't forget, smash that like.
Yep. Any questions, comments, leave them down below. We'll be sure to answer you as soon as possible.
Yes. So anyway, guys.
All right. Thanks for watching.
Peace.
Peace. Woo!